The U.S. Department of Defense has published a very interesting post. The DoD posted a video of the Ranger Unmanned Surface Vehicle, USV, testing a containerized 4-pack SM6 launcher. This provides an insight into the way the U.S. Navy intends to operate in the future. Small, unmanned platforms capable of launching deadly standoff weapons. Viewers may note that Ranger is an experimental vessel that's part of the service's Ghost Fleet Overlord program. SM6 is one of the most versatile weapons in the American arsenal. When integrated, these two systems can form a lethal combination. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how the U.S. Navy plans to take on the Russian and Chinese with Ghost Fleet armed with advanced weaponry. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by War Thunder. If you are, like us, fascinated by military vehicles and technology, I recommend you give War Thunder a try. It's a military vehicle combat game which you can download and play for free on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One with cross-platform support. It has a huge variety of more than 1,200 playable aircraft, tanks, helicopters, and ships from the 1930s to the 1990s, which you can take to battle on land, in the air, and at sea on more than 80 theaters of war. War Thunder's been kind enough to offer all Defense Updates viewers a special bonus, which will grant you a free premium tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account time for registering using our link in the description below. So take the plunge and join more than 20 million players from around the world. A large fleet of traditional manned ships is costly to operate and maintain. It's the need of the hour that few tasks are shifted to unmanned platforms. This also fits in the larger concept of having a more distributed and flexible fleet. U.S. Navy envisions a ghost fleet consisting of large, unmanned surface vehicles, LUSVs, medium unmanned surface vehicles, MUSVs, and extra-large unmanned undersea vehicles, XLUUVs. The vessels will be low-cost, high-endurance, and modular. That is, they'll be reconfigurable vessels and will be equipped according to mission requirements. While the U.S. Navy is still charting out long-term plans on Ghost Fleet, we have now got a glimpse of things to come. The goal of the Overlord program is to convert commercial fast supply vessels, which are used to service and resupply oil and gas platforms at sea, into an experimental unmanned ship that could navigate the ocean with or without human help. The U.S. Navy plans to acquire 2 LUSVs per year in FY 2020 to FY 2024. These will be between 200 feet to 300 feet in length and have a displacement of about 2,000 tons when fully loaded, making the LUSV the largest unmanned ship to date. These platforms will be packed with sensors of different types. Initially, these are expected to be unarmed, but eventually could be fitted with different types of launchers, including Mark 41 VLS, Vertical Launch System, which can provide a lot of flexibility as it can accommodate several kinds of weapons, like Tomahawk for land attack, VLASROC for anti-submarine operations, ESSM for the anti-missile role, apart from SM6. The Ranger is remotely controlled unmanned surface vehicle, USV, mainly tailored for working in shallow waters and able to perform intelligence, surveillance, and reconnaissance (IRS) operations and patrolling of predefined areas. The Ranger can be equipped with different kinds of sensors. The basic navigation suite includes compass, GPS, navigation camera, and controller with radio line. Ranger has the capability to perform both surface and underwater operations. It has radars and laser scanners for obstacle detection and tracking, daylight cameras, as well as thermal cameras, forward-looking sonars, etc. Ranger weighs around 1,800 kilograms, or 4,000 pounds, and has a speed of 75 kilometers per hour, or around 45 miles per hour. The vessel is made of aluminum. While currently the vessel's autonomous control system is not mature, it will keep getting better with more experiments and optimization. The RIM-174 Standard Extended Range Active Missile, ERAM, or Standard Missile 6, SM6, have been deployed by the U.S. Navy to counter different kinds of threats. It was designed for extended range anti-air warfare, ERAAW, purposes, providing capability against fixed and rotary wing aircraft, unmanned aerial vehicles, anti-ship cruise missiles in flight, both over sea and land, and terminal ballistic missile defense. It can also be used as a high-speed anti-ship missile and can also take out land targets. The missile uses the airframe of the earlier SM2ER Block 4 RIM-156A missile and some targeting elements from AIM-120C AMRAAM. It can discriminate targets using its dual-mode seeker, with the semi-active seeker relying on a ship-based illuminator to highlight the target, and the active seeker having the missile itself sending out an electromagnetic signal. SM6 has a max speed of Mach 3.5 and has a 140-pound, or 64-kilogram, blast fragmentation warhead. Since its mode of attack is partly ballistic in nature, it's much harder to defend against when compared to traditional cruise missiles. The U.S. has been fighting with adversaries that have no, or very small, navy like Iraq or Afghanistan. All this while Russia and China were not on the radar. America was focusing on military assets that were more in line with these battles, like the development of drones. But things have changed in the last decade. Russia and China have emerged as critical threats. Both of these countries have strong navies and are actively pursuing ways to counter the U.S. Navy by developing a wide variety of anti-ship missiles. Even second-tier powers like Iran have been pursuing the development of a wide range of anti-ship missiles. The U.S. Navy has been focusing on making the fleet more networked and distributed in view of the emerging threats. The distributed lethality concept aims to disperse firepower across different platforms, and Ghost Fleet is poised to play a crucial role in this.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.